What's going on, everyone? It's time for a horror comedy film review. Today we're going to talk about the classic film The Lost Boys. It was released sometime in the 80s by Warner Brothers Pictures, produced by Richard Donner, written by Janice Fisher, James Jeremias, and Jeffrey Boehm, and it's directed by Joel Schumacher, who did more other weird films like Trespass, 12, Blood Creek, and The Number 23. Those are more recent ones anyways. But yeah, The Lost Boys. Well, it stars Keith Sutherland too, by the way. But so mom got like divorced from her parents, or no, the mom, either the dad died or something, or is they're divorced, and they had to move to this Santa Cruz, California, or something like that, this boardwalk sort of town where her dad lives, and moves in with them with their kids, and as they go, and as the kids get to know the other people and kids and teens in the town, they realize there's a more darker secret to the town, and so they go, and what the oldest son basically hangs out with Kiefer Sutherland and his friends, and turns out they're huge covenant of vampires, and they're haunting and causing havoc in this town, and the younger son starts catching on to it, same with his buddies played by Corey Feldman and some other kid. And so they first try to convince the parents, like the mom, that there's vampires there, and obviously they don't believe them, so they have to go and take care of it themselves. Overall, this is a fun little movie. It's very amusing. The characters are pretty well written, and very relatable and stuff, especially for the younger people, especially of the times too. And overall, this is a really fun movie. It takes a little bit to get started in that, but all of them have their quirky moments and stuff. But it's neat how they crafted this, because the main characters are all the serious characters, and all the side characters usually do those main jokes and stuff, which is a little bit different, and it comes out of nowhere sometimes, and it's just a lot of fun, and they're always on time with their good comedic elements to this, and but they also keep it really dark. So for like the vampire stuff, this isn't like a Twilight Love vampire type of movie. This is a more darker version of it. And they definitely get in some pretty amusing scenes. Some really interesting kills happen in this. And overall, at first when I watched this when I was younger, I didn't like it, but it's been growing on me. I've seen it quite a few times. I have two different copies. So it's definitely a more fun film as I got older and understood it more. And it's quite a fun ride. The acting's really good, cinematography's really well done, and overall the effects and everything are pretty good too. And it's very like campy in some parts, but I think they could have did a little bit more with the vampires and stuff and make it a little more enticing. And but overall I really enjoyed this film. I wouldn't say it's a perfect movie. It does have some odd things and sort of dates itself a bit, but for the most part, it's still a really good classic vampire film, but the way vampire movies should be. So, I'm going to give The Lost Boys a 4 out of 5. I really enjoyed it. It's a lot of fun, and it's one of those rare vampire movies where you can see it much over and over again, and they don't do the cliche stuff. And, they try to do something different, and in this case, it worked. So, definitely a lot of fun. I'll link the trailer down below if you haven't seen it. You want to check that out, that's down there. Also, make sure you check out my Instagram, it's linked down below as well. That's where I post clips of films I'm going to review in the future. All my stories, you have the film title hashtag and some genre of film in the hashtag, so you're aware of it. And also, my letterbox is down below at AP Reviews. That's where I post my first star rating after watching the films. And also, I have Twitter now. So, if you want to check that out, it's reviews_Derek. So, follow me on one of those platforms. Stay in loop with this channel. Like this video, share some more people aware of it. Comment your opinions of the film down below if you have any. And also, if you want me to do the other two sequels so I can do the whole trilogy, let me know down below as well.
Make sure you subscribe.
Find something weird here and on that you probably never thought of checking out together. And also, so you hear my opinions on popular films that have come out, classic films like this, and reviews on other things as well. And also, don't forget to ring that bell because, well, I'm going to review a monster movie for the next one, A Quiet Place 2. So, yeah, make sure you tune in for that one. I think I did the first one already, but maybe not, but whatever. I'm reviewing that one next, so make sure you tune in for that. Watch out for all those teenage vampires causing problems in our towns, and I guess I'll see you all in the next one. So, until then, cheers.